Notion Calendar got a decent upgrade recently, and it allows you to now do a bit of task management like other apps that we know, like Akiflow, Trello, and many more. Let's explore what's new in terms of the task bit, whether you can use this as a daily planner, and get you started in roughly 5 minutes. So, okie dokie, here we are with the laptop, and let's show you around Notion Calendar and what's new. So, as you can see, this is the new task management area. You can use it as a daily planner. It can be fully functional for it. So, let me show you how to do it. So, if you scroll to the bottom of this left-hand side corner, you'll see your workspace, and what you'll see is the databases that you have connected to Notion Calendar. Now, essentially, what you can do is once you've chosen them, you select the one that you want to see, and then what you can do is very simply drag items on. Now, I can make these longer, and as you can see on this right-hand side, everything that you need to appears. A quick pause, guys. If you haven't yet got the Bento Focus app on iOS, it's one that we've created to help you better focus. Obviously, Notion is really powerful and fantastic for a lot of things, like many of the apps on the market, but this one really helps you to narrow down your focus and can be used as a companion app to things like Notion. It's got fantastic Japanese-inspired themes, focus bots, which helps you to narrow your tasks down to just 3, which helps you to better focus, and lots more. Check it out in the link in description. And everything syncs 2 ways with Notion, which means that you update the information here, and it will go back to Notion. Now, this is perfect because I can actually go ahead and click into it, modify all the details, archive it if I wish, because that's like doing it inside of your account, and assigning it to other people, which is perfect. Now, as you can see, the information is updated up here, but you can also modify the details as well and include multiple days or edit them in detail on the panel and copy the link from here. Now, I think this bit is where the real magic happens. If you go up to the top, you can actually change the color of the specific database that you're bringing in. So if you want it to be red or purple, you can, which is really nice for making that extra indication on your calendar of making sure that you see what you see. For example, you could have habits in green, work tasks in red, and personal tasks in purple. It's really dependent, but a lot of people like that visual color coding to get things done. So you can also use the filtering here to see things like property and details about each thing. And down here, you can go ahead and use individual views, which you can add as part of that. So why is that helpful? You're basically not restricted to the individualized view. So if you've got a more fine-tuned view of your habits, your tasks, or whatever, you can narrow it down from there. But what you can do on this left-hand side as well is hide certain ones as well. Now, why would you want to hide them? Well, the benefit to this is if you didn't want something showing up in your calendar, you didn't want to overwhelm yourself. For example, if you had a work area, a database, and a personal area, and you just wanted to do personal tasks, you can just show the personal tasks, which is really nice for making sure that you're zoned in on what particular activity you want to do. So if you want to go ahead and add any Notion database, you press that button and you choose which one you want to view. You have to search the database, find it, and bring it through, but it works just like that. So you can add any other items to the database and it will sync with Notion. You can add the context panel and manage it as if you were using it from the start. So let's not beat around the bush. That is what you can do with the new Notion calendar in planning. If you're already embedded deeply in Notion, this is going to be a whirlwind for you. It's probably going to be a great way to turn things into actionable things in your calendar and make it really customizable, which many people will like. Hopefully this gives you the confidence to use it as a daily planner, but there are other options. Trello, Akiflow, Sensama are all good daily planner tools if you're looking for an alternative, which you can find linked below. So thank you so much for stopping by today, folks. Hopefully that gave you a better idea of how to use Notion Calendar. I'll see you in a future video, and please do make sure to subscribe.